Hello children, I welcome you all to class 4 social studies, and today we are going to do revision for your midterm exam. So before we start the revision, let's see what's the question for your midterm exam. So the question is, first question is India, our nation, then the Himalayas, then the Northern Plate 1 and 2. So this is your third and fourth lesson. So next, the Great Indian Desert, this is your fifth lesson, and the Southern Plateaus, this is your sixth lesson. So these all lessons are there for your midterm exam, and you are going to do the revision one by one, okay? And then let's see what is the pattern for your exam. So first we have 20 marks objectives. Objectives in the sense, you have to write fill in the blanks, true or false, answer in one word, and MCQs. These all will be there for 1 marks each. And then answer the following. Answer in brief means you have to write in 2-3 sentence or 4-5 sentence like that. Then we will have one paragraph reading. How you will write in English now? Same, you have to read the paragraph and write few answers for that. So this is how you are going to write 20 marks for objectives and 30 marks for descriptives. So you will have total of 50 marks question. Okay. So this is the pattern for your exam. And this is your portion. So let's start the first lesson revision. So first lesson is India, our nation. And in first lesson you have fill in the blanks first. So India shares the border with Myanmar in the east. So this is your first fill in the blanks, and answer is Myanmar. You have to buy out the spelling of Myanmar in the fill in the blanks. Then only you will be able to write for your exam. Is it? Yes. Next, India is a subcontinent of, answer is Asia. And there are dash states in India. How many states are there total? Yes, there are 28 states in India. Earlier there were only 29 states. Now there are only 28 states. So the largest state in India is dash. Which is the largest state, children? Here we have the answer as Rajasthan. You have to buy the spelling of Rajasthan also. The capital of Jharkhand is dash. Which is the capital city of Jharkhand, children? That is Ranchi. Then you come to the short answers. In short answer, first one, name the water body that borders southwest of India. So which is this? Arabian Sea. Arabian Sea is the water body that borders in the southwest of India. So this is your first answer. Next, who are our neighbors in Indian Ocean? So Sri Lanka and Maldives are our neighbors in Indian Ocean. This is your answer for second question. Is it? Yes. Then third one, how many union territories are there in India? Name them. You have to write the number also, and you have to write the names also one by one. Okay. And here you need to buy out the spellings also. Then only you will be able to write the names. So there are 8 union territories, and they are, first one, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, second one, Chandigarh, then third one, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, and Daman and Diu, and fourth one is National Capital Territory of Delhi, then fifth one, Lakshadweep Island, next Puducherry, and the next Jammu and Kashmir and Leh in Ladakh. So these are all the 8 union territories in India. So you need to buy out the spellings also. Then only you will be able to write. Andaman and Nicobar spelling, Chandigarh spelling, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, then Puducherry, Lakshadweep, Leh, Ladakh. This is a new word. So you have to buy out these all spellings. Okay, children? So next, fourth one. Why is southern part of India called as peninsula? The southern part of India is called as peninsula because it is surrounded by 3 sides of water and 1 side by land. I know You all know this answer, is it? Yes, it's very easy. You should remember three sides water and one side land. So only it's called as peninsula. Union territory government is different from government of state. The difference between union territory and state government is state government has its own elected government, whereas union territory is ruled by the president of India through his representatives. You are going to write the difference between both the union territories and state government. So union territory is ruled by the president of India through his representatives. That is the difference. Whereas state government is ruled by its own elected government. Okay. Then next is answer the following in brief. You need to write this point wise. Okay. You have to write it point wise. First one is explain the geographical features of India. So answer is India measures 3,214 kilometers from north to south and 2,993 kilometers from east to west. This is your first point. Okay, where you are writing 3,214 kilometers from north to south and 2,993 kilometers from east to west. And the southern part of India is surrounded by three water bodies, that is Indian Ocean, Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea. This is your first point. Then next one, India shares land borders with Pakistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Republic of China, Myanmar and Bangladesh. So these are the countries named Pakistan, Nepal, Republic of China and Myanmar and Bangladesh. You need to buy out all these spellings, children. Then only you will be able to write the answer. Okay. Then Sri Lanka and Maldives are our neighbors in Indian Ocean. So this is your next point. And the northern part of India is protected by high mountains. This is your last point of the first answer. So first one, you are going to write the measurement of India, that is 3,214 kilometers and 2,993 kilometers from all the four directions. Then water bodies, then next comes the countries names, and then neighboring countries in Indian Ocean you have to write. Then last one is northern part of India is covered by high mountains. This is your first answer. Is it? Okay, it's clear, I think. Now the second question. Next question is, why is India referred to as a country that shows unity in diversity? This is your second question of long answer, and you are going to write, people in India speak many languages. This is your first point. Then they follow different religion and celebrate number of festivals. Then next one is, wear variety of dresses and yet they stay together in one country, and hence India is referred to as a country that shows unity in diversity. This is your last answer of the first lesson. Okay, and I have said 4 points you have to write. This may be asked for 4 marks question. So point wise if you write, it will be easy. For 3 marks you need to write 3 points. For 4 marks you need to write 4 points. So it will be easy. Each 1 point will get 1 mark. Is it? And it will be easy for you to remember also. Like this, you are going to do the revision of first lesson. I think it's clear. You need to write 2 to 3 times and practice all the spellings, because you are going to write the spellings of countries, states and all, union territories. These all you have to write and practice, children. Today's homework will be, you have to write all these question answers 1 or 2 times and practice it. Okay, I think it's clear. So we'll meet in the next session. Till then, take care. Thank you.